One highlight over the past year has been the developing partnership between Prairie Music and Arts and the Sun Prairie Community Schools. A big part of our school mission is making opportunities in the arts inclusive and accessible. And as such, the partnership with the community schools has allowed PMA to reach even more students through visual art and drama activities at Westside Elementary, C.H. Byrd Elementary, and Patrick Marsh Middle School here in Sun Prairie. These programs are only possible through the generosity of others, and we are fortunate to have the support of the Sun Prairie Education Foundation, the Exchange Club of Sun Prairie, the Sun Prairie Community Schools, and private donors who help bridge the gap between tuition and the true cost of maintaining programs such as these. We thank all of our supporters and appreciate you being our partner to create meaningful programs that make a difference.
Hi, my name is Jamie Racine, and I'm the Sun Prairie Community Schools Program Coordinator. I want to take a moment and say congratulations to all of the artists that are showcased here tonight, and also give a nod of gratitude to the Prairie Music and Arts staff and leadership, who have been great collaborators and partners with community schools. And a nod of gratitude as well to our site coordinator staff that have supported these programs and helped to get students and families involved. So thank you to everybody that made tonight possible. I hope you enjoy the show.
So I'm gonna be playing the drum set, and I'm basically just laying down the foundation, like what Matt said. Basically just gonna be keeping the time. I'm using jazz brushes today. I've been really practicing a lot with them. I got them a short time ago, so I've been really trying to get it in, kind of get used to them. So I got the beat down, and I've been listening to the song a lot, trying to get a feel for where things are.
Chase, can you just give us an example of a little bit of what Matt was just talking about?
It is like a circular motion with your left hand, and then like it's a regular rising pattern with your right. So it's like.
So yeah, like Kyle said, there is no guitar part in the song, so we kind of improvise. Like, since I got a capo recently, it allows me to like move up the fretboard, so like the notes sound different in different spots, like you make them higher in different octaves. And so we have to improvise with that and try to come up with like certain chords that would like fit along with the song and like sound proper.
And some of what you're doing is maybe fairly similar to what the piano part is doing, but then we're also kind of incorporating some other elements, playing some of the counter melodies, like in that intro that I think you hear in the original recording, like the clarinet, or I think there's like a string section, or There's just a lot of instruments in this recording. So we're trying to kind of mix and match with that. Do you have your guitar handy, Sophia? Would you want to demonstrate just maybe the intro of this song, or just kind of give people a feel for what you're doing?
Piano in this song is really providing harmony, though there is quite a bit in that introduction as well. Caitlin, can you give us a little bit of a taste of what you've been working on?
You want me to play like some of the chords?
Yeah, just play a little bit of the first verse.
Okay.
Layla, how has that process been for you? Or like, can you walk through some of the things that we've done to sort of discover what we want to do in each section and paying attention to the phrasing of each part too, and how that plays into what we decide to do as a performer.
Yeah, normally we take it section by section and we like listen to the original melody so we know what like notes we can play around with. And then we take those notes and we make it fit more for my voice, and we just take it line by line to work with it.
Yeah, and then since everyone shared just a little bit of what they've been doing, would you be comfortable doing just from, so the beginning, you've got a friend in me, up to before we get to da-da-da-da, wait, hang on. No, let's just do the first chunk. This one's harder to like break and piece apart.
Yeah.
Okay.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said, for you've got a friend in me.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's what we've been doing. And it's a little bit different every time, trying to keep it special, but keep it recognizable enough that that main melody's there.
Good evening. I am Rebecca Zahn, the principal at Patrick Marsh Middle School. I would like to take a moment to extend our sincere gratitude to Prairie Music and Arts for their collaboration with our students for tonight's incredible event. We are proud to be a community school, and we greatly appreciate all of their support, and including our students. And bravo to our students for all the work that they have done.
Let's start first by talking about what the process has been in putting together this project.
So we had to, this song presented some unique challenges because we had to put an arrangement together. We had to figure out what instrumentation we had and what it was going to sound like all together. But because of the pandemic, we haven't really been able to be in the same room together up until today. And even then, we still don't have our singer.
Even though it feels like a very unique kind of like pandemic experience for us, there's like this process that exists kind of in the professional recording world that is not too far off from what we're doing here.
So we're going to talk about what the process of drawing our art is based on the listening experience. But I'm going to pass that question on to you guys if you want to think about the process of making it and any challenges that you encounter.
I find that one thing that's really hard is putting what you have in your head on a piece of paper or canvas, especially when I was first playing it out. I had an idea and then I couldn't. You know what you want to do, but you can't quite visualize it completely and fully. So then you're trying to figure out the colors. When you have it all done, you're like, well, I don't really like what I did, just to kind of just work off of that. And there's kind of like, what to do now? That's why. Mm-hmm.
All right, Rebecca?
For me, I tend to think that it's difficult for me because I tend to like think in my mind that I'm not very good at imagining things and like finding ideas to put down. So I kind of just move randomly with my thing, and then it just is all like jumbled together and it never looks good.
To our performers, what challenges has this process presented to you, especially with the virtual component?
I can go. So one challenge that I had while playing this song is with the guitar. The original sheet that we had was like a total different, like had total different chords than what, like in total different key than I was supposed to be playing. So it was pretty hard to like learn all the new chords on top of total different chords on the piano as well. So that was my challenge with this piece.
I can add on to that. I think the hardest part was learning the two different parts and trying to see where they fit in together, as well as trying to imagine what everybody else's parts go with. And I think that was just a weird experience, but it was also fun.
I can go. I think the hardest part personally is not being in person with you guys, because I'm obviously not there, and just doing it all virtually is really different and really weird. So it's a change.
A tough part for me was, I guess I'm used to it as a drummer. You don't really get a part. You just get usually like what the guitar or bass is playing, and you have to listen to the song on your own and hear what the drummer and the actual song is playing and then go off that. But you don't play exactly what the drummer is playing because you don't want to be an exact copy of them. So you have to put your own stuff in there and listen to the song and get the idea of it.
One more question. And I think this will maybe lend itself as much to our singer. The lyrics of the song are often really important for expressing the emotional intent of the song. So what do you feel these lyrics are trying to express to the listener?
So how I kind of interpret the song is things are going to get better no matter how bad it seems, which is really important to listen to during COVID and like quarantine when you can't see people as much. So just knowing that it's going to get better, which is a really important message to spread.
Well, I think the lyrics themselves are rather hopeful, upbeat, but it's also kind of melancholy. Like you're realizing that things aren't great in the moment and they might get better, but it's not right in this moment. And like Dakota was saying, we're like kind of like COVID's sort of ending, not quite, but it's maybe over that hill, maybe. And so how it's gonna get better, but it's not all that great right now. And we can't always focus on the now. And we have to remember that it's gonna get better.
Nice interpretation. Right, Rebecca?
It's hard to work off that because that's basically exact things I was gonna say. It's just exactly what's happening. Like things are gonna get better, but they're not very great right now. Mm-hmm. For me, in the actual world, it's probably gonna take a while to get, I don't know if it's ever gonna be normal. It's gonna be normal.
For me, that's one of the greatest joys about doing like a recording project like this, you know, is actually being in the same room, you know, because you're capturing audio recording, right? You're capturing the music, but you're also capturing like a moment in time, right? And you're capturing a meeting of minds, a meeting of creativity. And I have some recordings that I've done with friends, you know, similar to this, that every time I listen to them, I'm like teleported back to that moment in time. And it kind of like fills me with this like warm communal feeling. So I hope that you guys got a chance to experience that collaborative joy as well in this process.
I think that's something we've all been missing over the past year. And it, for me, it is, has really filled me up just seeing all of you in the building. It's really great to see.
Brighter. Ooh, child, bright.